Hare Krishna, watch yourself as if you are someone you don't know. Whenever we want to learn about someone, we observe them carefully to see how they act, what they do, and how they respond in various different situations. We can adopt that same approach toward ourselves. Now we may say, why do we need to do that? It's because we don't know ourselves. How can we not know ourselves? Because we are too complicated. Our minds are complicated. We have many desires and many levels of desires. We have many invisible hurts. And we could almost say that there are many sub-personalities who are diverse and who are only loosely united as the one person who we think we are. And the fact that we don't know ourselves can be seen from the fact that we sometimes shock ourselves. We act in unexpected ways. We act in undesirable ways. In fact, we act in ways which we have resolved we will not act that way. And we are not able to control ourselves on many occasions. So therefore, if we want to understand ourselves, what are the forces operating within us? What is the nature of those forces? How strong are which forces? When do they get activated? And how can we learn to deter them or restrain them? For understanding all this, we can observe ourselves carefully. And such self-observation is vital for self-transformation. So the Bhagavad-Gita points to such self-observation when it says in 6.5, Uddhared Atmanatmanam Natmanam Avasadayet Atmaivayatmano Bandhur Atmaivaripuratmanaha. That elevate yourself with yourself and don't degrade yourself with yourself. You are the self is the best friend of the self and the self is the worst enemy of the self. What this means is that the Gita is recommending us to create an observer and observed kind of pattern within us by which we can be the observer while we are also the observed. And thus we can, when, just as if we were counseling or guiding someone and that person starts acting unhealthily, undesirably, then immediately we would caution them, counsel them. So similarly, we can counsel and caution ourselves, provided we are observing ourselves. So we are a mystery, not just to others, but even to ourselves. And by treating ourselves as a mystery that needs to be investigated, not in the sense that we lose ourselves in self-obsession, thinking of nothing but ourselves, not in a self-indulgent sense that we just think about ourselves and of nothing else, but rather we observe ourselves so that we can learn about ourselves and learn how best we can work with ourselves and how we can bring the best out of ourselves. That is the way ultimately to spiritual advancement, because we have a spiritual essence within us, and which is pure, which is potent, which is divine. And there are many impure, ungodly and destructive forces also within us. So when we observe ourselves, we can see those destructive forces acting and check them. And again, when we observe ourselves, we can see when the divinity within us is manifesting and we can channel and encourage it. And in that way, we can be our friend and not our enemy. Thank you. Hare Krishna.